As the Tea Party's influence on the Republican Party grows, plenty of traditional Republicans are being forced out of that not-so-big-anymore tent. Forced out to make way for the Mama Grizzlies, the Joe Millers, the Sharon Angles, and the Christine no-relation O'Donnells, underscoring the point, the latest NBC News Wall Street Journal poll showing that 71% of people who identify themselves as Republicans also say they're Tea Party supporters. On the right, the talk is all about the Tea Party tax cuts for the rich, resisting the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and taking back the country from the terrifying left. And left out in the cold, Republican pragmatists and moderates, many who no longer recognize their party. Tonight, one of them steps into our spotlight. Author of the new book, Dirty Sexy Politics, Meghan McCain. Meghan, thank you very much for joining us
tonight. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
I have a few questions for you.
Sure.
In shaping your worldview, I'm just curious, what newspapers and magazines, that's a joke, that you know, you saw the questions
Johnson,
I asked Levi
yes.
the other night.
Yeah, I actually get asked that question a lot. I think it's become this question that people ask people
it's
now.
It's the Katie Couric question to Sarah Palin, basically, do you read the paper? And she had no, and she said she read all of them.
Do you want to hear a piece of trivia? I never actually saw that full interview because I was on the campaign on my own at the time and I've only seen clips of it.
So. All right, we're showing it to you before you leave tonight.
Okay.
We have it. What about, you know, I'm the parent of a daughter.
How old is she?
She is 16. And there came a time, I didn't realize this immediately, but it came a time years ago that I realized I better own up to my mistakes. You know, if I'm telling her she made a mistake because she should have done this instead of that, I better own up to mine. So when did your father come to you after the election and say, Meghan, that Palin thing was the craziest thing
this
I've ever done in my life. The presidential election.
He's ran twice, so.
Presidential election. When did he come to you and say, the Palin choice was the biggest mistake of my life?
He's never said anything
what?
Like that to me.
He didn't?
No.
So what does that do to father-daughter credibility? I mean, because you know it was the biggest mistake of his life.
I don't think it's the biggest mistake of his life at all. I think she brought a lot of momentum to my father's campaign, and she brought some negative things, and history can judge it. My family doesn't like to look back. It's a pretty great trait. We don't sit around the table talking about the election. Thank God. I'd probably never go home. It's just not something to talk about.
See, the Irish look back because we know there's nothing to look forward to. It's a whole other culture. You Southwesterners live in optimism and sunshine. It's a whole different thing. The question that the audience is waiting for is, who's right on Don't Ask, Don't Tell, Lady Gaga or Senator John McCain?
Well, I don't believe in entertainers reaching their head into politics as a general rule. I find it kind of infuriating. I think everyone should stick to their mold and what they do.
Can I stop you and ask you two words?
Ronald Reagan.
Yeah. You are so good at this. Did you see my cards?
No, but I've
got
that before.
Okay, go ahead.
But I think when you're, you know, known for wearing raw meat at the MTV Awards, maybe. I'm against my father, obviously. I'm against Don't Ask, Don't Tell. I took a lot of heat when my father obviously passed the bill. You know, it's been a point of contention, not personally. It's not like I go home and talk about it, but mm-hmm. obviously, publicly, people still seem to vent anger at me about it. Me and my mother both posed for the No Hate campaign. The world knows where I stand. I'm not a politician.
But, you know, and you say entertainers shouldn't, you know, insert
and I mean
themselves
sort of
in here.
The, Ben
what if
Affleck.
They're right? I mean, what if the entertainer is right? I mean,
they
you
can.
Think
I
Lady
just,
Gaga is
you know,
right.
I would rather hear from politicians and professors and pundits and journalists for my information.
All right. Now, there is the Tea Party is the 71% of your party supports in some sense the Tea Party. Are you one of the 71% who in some way supports the Tea Party?
I'm really conflicted because I understand where the anger is coming from. I understand that it's about the spending. Where it gets hazy for me, and I think a lot of other young people, is this weird race stuff. I don't understand it. It makes me very uncomfortable. I think my generation is very post-racial. So that's where it gets really hazy for me. I understand where the frustration is coming from, and I think the Obama presidency sort of made this all possible. So I'm conflicted.
And then there's that new plank in the Tea Party platform in Delaware, that Christine O'Donnell has introduced, this kind of personal behavior thing.
Yes.
Don't worry, I'm not going to use the word. I'm too polite for that. But this is just a yes or no, okay?
Is this what
Do I'm you agree with Christine O'Donnell on you know what? It's just yes or no.
God.
It's just yes or no.
If I were running for office, anti-masturbation would not be the platform
it would
I
not.
Would choose.
You would, you're a libertarian on that
yes,
one. Yeah, okay. I think, that's the rest of the O'Donnell family's position. I'm telling you, you can't find another O'Donnell who agrees with her. We all do. I can't even use the word.
I think it's weird, but whatever, do her thing.
It is,
whatever.
As we say in Boston, wicked weird. It's beyond, it's beyond weird.
It works for her, whatever.
Now, what is it like? You're 25 now?
Yeah, I'm almost 26.
Okay. What is it like at this age, which is, you know, the prime age group for Lady Gaga fans and you know, that part of our culture, to have that kind of whole culture coming down on your dad over this particular issue, Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and then just in general, you know, treating him as an old fogey and the young Democrat running for president is the cool way to go.
Mm-hmm.
How uncool do you feel when you're stuck in that corner?
I don't feel uncool. I never have
felt
uncool.
And you don't look uncool, and you don't sound uncool.
Thank you.
So there's a lot of coolness going on over there.
And I like Lady Gaga. I just think it's, you know, again, like, I'd like her to sing me Paparazzi, and, you know, I'll go to her concerts. I just don't want her to yell at my dad anymore.
She doesn't yell. I thought she was pretty eloquent in the way she addressed him. I was surprised, you know, because there was no indication she could really put a sentence together outside of, you know, lyrics.
But if you want Middle America to come around to Don't Ask, Don't Tell, she really isn't the vessel I would use to talk to Middle America. Someone like me or my mother would really be the person I would send to the heartland to talk about Don't Ask, Don't Tell. Unfortunately, she's an entertainer and a very avant-garde one. I don't think that farmers in Midland America are necessarily going to be listening to her on this issue.
How many Twitter followers do you and your mother have?
I have like 90-something thousand. How many do you have?
8 or 9. But Lady Gaga has something like 18 million or something.
She's got
like more than Obama and more than the Pope, I think. She's got more Twitter followers than the Pope.
I think she's the most followed person,
yeah. So, I mean, that's what the answer to that is. Mm-hmm. Like people who want this to happen are thrilled. I think thrilled that you and your mother are where you are on this subject. And I think anyone can understand that that's not an easy thing, you know, given your father's position. But you know, Lady Gaga gets the attention to it. More attention than even you can.
But she was not effective.
Well, we'll see, I guess. Right? We're going to see. I mean, next year we'll know who wins this thing, John McCain or Lady Gaga.
It's true. I hate that this is the beast
that's what
is
it's
going
that's
on.
That's what our politics have come down to. Meghan McCain, thank you very, very much for joining me in the studio tonight. Your book, Dirty Sexy Politics, on sale everywhere now.